Okay, a progress update on my new mod, Ancient Times. The reason for I haven't made any videos this last week is that I have been busy on this mod, and I have been busy otherwise in general, so that's why I don't haven't gotten any videos. But anyway, I got some progress to show off for it. So the focus is not the map, but you can obviously see that there has been some progress on that. But the main part of the effort have been the event system. So the event system, at least so much of it there is so far, is to work together with the laws. So that depending on the faction in power, you can enact different laws. So let's check it out. So, already at the start, we get a bunch of events. Let's take this one first. Political changes. The conservative and liberal parts of a tribe fight once again. Who do you favor? So, as you can see in the politics screens, you got the social conservatives and you got the social liberals. These want a more modern, more industrial society. These want a more tradition, warrior-based society. That may not be as productive, though. Even if they fight better. So you can choose which side to empower, and there's a percentage chance that you can get 25, 50, or 75% increase in popularity. Or else it may backfire and the other side may actually be empowered instead. Or you can empower the middle ground, which you can barely see. You can't actually see them, but they are these ones, which can implement liberal policies, but are closer to the conservatives. So for now, let's pick the liberal. Let's see the changes. Oh, it seems it actually backfired. Well done. So anyway, you will get some events that will pop up, and for this one, once you have a certain party at a certain strength and some other factors, these events will fire, and this one will increase the economic laws here to make you more industrial, to make you more powerful production-wise. So you can either refuse, which means you can't enact a law again for January now, so until October, so that's a long while. So you can't get another one of these events until then. Or you can approve it, and then you only have to wait until July to get the next possible event. But you need to have the requirements for that event as well, so it may not fire in July. It may take to August, September or something for you to fulfill the requirements for that. And if you don't have enough liberals in your politics, it may not fire at all. Unless until you get enough liberals, that is. So for now, let's enact that. So it won't automatically enact, but as you can see here, it will allow you to change, but yeah, they cost money to enact, so let's also approve this one. This one you don't really have a choice, and that is the traditional limits. This one depends if you have liberals or conservatives as your ruling party. And depending on the strength, you will automatically go up and down that tree, depending on your ruling party strength. So, yeah. Getting more conservative. And now let's wait for us to get enough money to enact that law. In the meantime, we can also enact schools to improve our leadership percentage. But we also need money for that, so now we should have enough. So let's enact some few legal rights. You only need the event though if you are a conservative. As you can see, if you're liberal, you can enact this one right away without having a certain power percentage or an event. But as you're a conservative, you need to wait for the event. But if you're totalitarian, you can just say fuck it and do it anyway, even if you're a conservative. Now let's see if we have a ford with the law. No, not yet. Now let's refresh it and get schools for the elite, which will cost a little bit money. Now let's run this for half a year and see if we get more events. And that was some more of the map. Yeah, right, we have to manually enact this as well. It's that reversion can't be denied. But maybe I should change that to be automatic though. Yeah, and also you got some decisions you can take. You may be familiar with the prepare for war one, which will lower your neutrality. There's also a be aggressive one, which does the same, but not as much. And there's also a be peaceful one, once you want to return to peace, actually increasing your neutrality. Because this mod is not intended to only be a war game, but also managing the factions and religion while you are at peace. Now, let's see at politics, because we got the political stability event. Now, if one of the more extreme parties, like militant traditionalists and others, or the extremely progressive side, gets more than 5% support, we'll get one of these events. This will give more popularity and strength to the moderate parties, which will diminish the power of these ones, because these ones are required to push through laws. But if these are not strong, these ones are strong instead, you can't actually do anything. So it's to make sure it actually works. But yeah, let's keep waiting. You might notice that the flags are a bit fucked up. And that's a bug. Now, we've got a political offer. The middle ground liberals has approached you with valuables in order to get your secret support and so on. This means that, well, there is no downside to this. You can always refuse it to no consequences. But if you approve, one of the three moderate parties will gain organization, and the middle ground liberal starts with actually no organization. So if you prove, you can make them become the new powerful party and get more percentage in the future. And that political stability event will also take notice to that and adapt if the middle ground liberals tend to be powerful instead. Got a new offer already, that's a bit strange. Sure. Now, enact many traditional limits. Also, most of the countries are democracies, which they should be in order so you can change your ruling party. So there's election for every country every 3 years, except a certain few which are dictatorships. So let's enact that one, giving us more or less national unity changes. If you get a negative hit, it won't be as damaging. And you get more dissent though, but here you get more ruling party support. And once you get, also when you get down to these ones, you will also be able to enforce other laws, regardless of your party in power and their strength. So, yeah, that's how it works. And I think that's pretty much it. I've shown off how it basically works. So, yeah, expect an open beta to get your guys' opinions of the mod within a week. So, well, look forward to that or not. Anyway, thanks for watching.